Everybody has that calm spirit.
Welcome, welcome, welcome to Recovery Church, Norfolk, Virginia. Come on and give God a hand clap. I'm going to bring up someone that we just near and dear to us. One of the founder from Jupiter, Florida, is here tonight, and also one of his key pastors, Pastor Junior. Come on up, Pastor Phil and Pastor Junior. We came all the way from Florida to help us launch tonight, and we're so grateful for being here. This is our very first service, and we just bless God. If you're watching tonight and you're in recovery, 5405 Pendleton Street, north of Virginia, this is the place to be to support your recovery. Amen.
Amen.
And I'm going to ask Pastor Phil if he'll come up and he'll say a word of prayer and anything else he'd like to say. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Pastor Green, thank you. Guys, we're honored to be here. We're honored to see what God is going to do in this place, through this place, in and through each one of you. You know, God is moving. We're seeing people across the country find a path to recovery and a relationship with Jesus.
Yeah.
And we're going to see Recovery Church Norfolk blow up with people finding Jesus to find a path at recovery. So there are a couple of brave people out here. There are people that many of us know who have died without that path of recovery, and some of them without the saving grace of Jesus. So we want to change that. So let's pray. Let's pray for a blessing. You know what? Before we do that, Drew, you say something real quick.
Wasn't prepared for this, but guys, I'm excited to be here.
Amen.
Thank you guys for having us. And, you know, when we first met with, you know, Pastor Green, Pastor McNair, and Pastor Myrna, we just knew. You know, they are just filled with the Spirit, and you just know that God was moving in this place. And one thing that I heard about this place, the Burning Bush, is as people came in here, the one thing that was consistent was this. They felt something when they came in.
Amen.
And I believe what they felt was the presence of God. And if the presence of God is here, healing, breakthrough is in this place. Change is going to break. Freedom is going to be found. God is going to move in this place. And we're excited that we get to be part of this. So thank you guys so much for coming out. And I truly believe that this is the beginning of something great.
Amen. Amen.
You guys join me in prayer. Dear Heavenly Father, Lord, we thank you for what you've done and what you're doing. We thank you how you've brought this team together and you're bringing this team together. We thank you for the hearts that were moved to already come into this space and those that you're drawing here, Lord. We thank you for the person who right now is walking the cold streets and lost, but you're stirring in their heart and that they're going to find this refuge. They're going to find this hope in Jesus, and they're going to find a path of recovery, Lord. Right now, we pray that you move through the city, that you spark hearts to be able to draw near to you, Lord. And as they draw near to you, you draw near to them, Lord.
Yes.
Lord, may you bless this team and bless them abundantly, Lord. May you fill them with your Spirit, fill them with your power, and may as they speak, the words be your words and nothing more and nothing less, Lord.
Yes.
We ask for your blessing and your power. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
Thank you, Lord.
Come on, give God some praise. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. This ain't no ordinary worship. Amen. Hallelujah. This ain't no ordinary worship.
No.
This ain't no ordinary praise.
No.
We just gonna let it all hang out.
Hey.
Because if you're not recovering, you already recovered. Come on.
So
you gotta give God some to praise. You got some to praise him for. Amen.
Hallelujah.
You have a made up mind. Hallelujah.
Come on.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Thank you, Lord.
This ain't all their worship, y'all.
Amen.
Thank you. Anybody got a made up mind?
Hallelujah.
If you do something, sing this song.
I'm made up and I won't turn back, cause I want to see my Jesus someday. I got my Jesus' name so sweet.
Churches reaching and training those in early recovery to grow in faith, in their faith and recovery, and it's Recovery Church Norfolk. RCN is a bridge between the 12-step fellowships and the church. We train, coach, and help people learn to become disciples and disciple makers within the recovery community. We don't just want disciples. We want you to turn around and become makers and doers of the word.
Amen. Amen.
Yeah.
The service schedule is as follows. Recovery Church North Norfolk is every Friday between 7 and 8:30 p.m. and is found at Burning Bush Worship Center. And every Burning Bush Worship Center meets every Sunday at 11:30 a.m. Although if you want to come at p.m., Pastor won't mind. I won't be here, but the Holy Ghost will be here.
Come on. Hallelujah.
And, of course, Burning Bush Worship Center is 405 Pendleton Street in the great city of Norfolk. There's connection forms. We want to know how to serve you. We're not about us just standing up here talking, but we want to know what you want. And the connection forms are in the back on the snack table. And I believe at some point in period, we're going to be able to have it on our link. And so that way somebody can download it. Those of you that are live streaming won't have to come all the way here, but you'll be able to get it. And you drop your connection form in the collection basket on the way out. Also, like I said, if you're on live streaming, there'll be a way that you can send it to us and we'll get in contact with you. The contact info for Recovery Church is recovery.church/Norfolk. And the phone number is area code 443-297-9811. Or you can reach us at burningbushwc.org. And that phone number is 757-543-4254. And of course, as I said, we're at 405 Pendleton Street. There's service opportunities. I love this part. The Recovery Church Norfolk has many ways you can help to serve. Every Friday, come before or by 6:30 p.m. to help out. Share your talents and abilities to enhance our service. I may be able to pray and speak, but you may be able to cook something wonderful. Or you have that kind of disposition where everybody loves to be around you. Don't hide it under a bushel. Come on out. We need you.
Yes.
You may think that you don't need us, and maybe you don't, but we need you.
Amen. Thank you.
All right.
We do have one major reminder. Smoking is established outside and near the designated area. What we ask is that you please use the ashtrays that are there and throw away cups and bottles before you enter back into the building. Going through the 12 steps, who here is available to be a sponsor? Please raise your hands. Who is here looking for a sponsor? Please raise your hand. Surrender crosses. Come get your cross. We give out surrender crosses every service, and we give out anniversary crosses monthly. I'll explain what the crosses are. Recovery Church gives out crosses to denote various lengths of sobriety. Our first cross is called a desire or a surrender cross. This is a tangible reminder of the changes we want to make in our lives. We're asking people to come and receive a cross to represent this transition. During most weeks, we'll present the initial surrender cross. However, doing anniversary nights, 30 days, 60 days, 90 days, 6 months, 9 months, 1 year, and of course, multiple years, we'll have special crosses to denote that. And of course, the anniversaries will always take place on the last of the month. If you want to have a surrender cross, you will step over on, that would be the right side of the church. We're hoping that you spread the word through text, through telling, and through sharing on Facebook, Instagram, Twitter. We're sensitive to everyone's privacy. Attendees receiving crosses and sharing will not be streamed. Only the stage will be live streamed. So please plan to attend. Have a great evening, everyone.
Amen.
Come on and give God a hand clap. Song by Cecilia.
I'm back.
Yes.
Now I want everybody to get up this time. Come on. You know how you were when you were at the club. Don't tell nobody. Come on, get your little rock out. Thank you. a good God. Send your thanks unto the Lord. For He is good. Is He good all the time? All the time God is good. Hallelujah. 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 He's a way maker. A miracle worker. A light in the darkness. Anybody ever been in a dark place?
My God, that is who you are.
already did the work.
Hallelujah.
Everything he did was free.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Never stop working.
Come on.
Never stop working.
Thank you.
All right, this is like going to a sermon, Pastor.
Come on.
Never stop working.
That's what the power of God is doing for you on the inside.
Hallelujah.
It manifests itself what? On the outside.
Come on.
Amen. Amen. This is a part of the service that we often can participate in. We're going to just pass the offering plate. Perhaps you have an offering to give. Give it. If not, just touch the plate and tell the Lord.
Amen.
And bless
Amen.
The Lord.
Come
Amen.
On.
Amen. Pastor Dean, would you come up and assist?
Yeah.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Amen. We bless God. Amen. I'm going to just go ahead and pray before you go out. You go ahead and pray.
Heavenly Father, we just thank you for the privilege to be here tonight. As we prepare, Lord, to give these tithes and offering, Lord, we pray that you touch our hearts, Lord.
Yes.
Because you said you love a cheerful giver, Lord.
Hallelujah.
And Father, we just pray, Lord God, that we can give, Lord God, generously, Lord, and with a right spirit.
Amen.
Bless those, Lord, that have it. Remember those have a desire, but have none.
Yes.
We give you praise and we give you all the glory. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Amen.
I just wanna thank you,
yes,
forever and ever and ever.
Testimony, and I want to remind everyone that's watching, after the message and we do an altar call, we will stop streaming, amen, because this is the time where we're going to have a break and then we'll have a snack table beautifully set up in the rear, as I can tell, and an opportunity for those who would like to go outside. If they smoke, they can go outside and smoke. How many know that God is still working on us?
Amen. Amen. Come on, preach it.
I think we're all under construction. Amen.
Yes, we are.
So we just want to kind of give you the order, because for you at home, you will stop seeing us stream, because
Once we come back, we're going to give the opportunity for everyone that is in recovery to share their story. And I know there's some stories in here because I've heard them before. Amen. And they can share their story of recovery. Because that's how we get blessed, and we can actually not only share our stories, but that story can help somebody else go and share a story. Amen. Amen. So we just bless God. Come on and give God a hand clap. I just want to share a few words with you tonight. I was in the Recovery Bible, and I saw some a scripture and some information that I wanted to share with you tonight. It came out of 2 Kings, the 5th chapter, verses 1 through 15. And if you would, if you don't mind, if you can honor God's word by standing, I'm going to read those scriptures. And while we stand, and for you at home, you can find your Bibles and you can read those scriptures. 2 Kings, the 5th chapter, verses 1 through 15. Amen?
Amen.
And it reads, "Now Naaman was commander of the army of the king of Aram. He was a great man in the sight of his master and highly regarded, because through him the Lord had given victory to Aram, and he was a valiant soldier, but he had leprosy. Now bands of raiders from Aram had gone out and had taken captive a young girl from Israel, and she served Naaman's wife. She said to her mistress, 'If only my master would see the prophet who is in Samaria, he would cure him of his leprosy.' Naaman went to his master and told him what the girl from Israel had said. 'By all means go,' the king of Aram replied. 'I will send a letter to the king of Israel.' So Naaman left, taking with him 10 talents of silver, 6,000 shekels of gold, and 10 sets of clothing. The letter that he took to the king of Israel read, 'With this letter I am sending my servant Naaman to you, so that you may cure him of his leprosy.' As soon as the king of Israel read the letter, he tore his robes and said, 'Am I God? Can I kill and bring back to life? Why does this fellow send someone to me to be cured of his leprosy? See how he is trying to pick a quarrel with me.' When Elijah, the man of God, heard that the king of Israel had torn his robes, he sent him this message: 'Why have you torn your robes? Have the man come to see me, and he will know that there is a prophet in Israel.'
Amen.
So Naaman went with his horses and chariots and stopped at the door of Elijah's house. Elijah sent a messenger to say to him, and I'll read this again. Elijah sent a messenger to say to him, 'Go wash yourself 7 times in the Jordan, and your flesh will be restored, and you will be cleansed.'
Okay.
But Naaman went away angry and said, 'I thought that he would surely come out to me and stand and call on the name of the Lord, his God, wave his hand over the spot and cure me of my leprosy. Are not Bana and Far, the rivers of Damascus, better than all the waters of Israel? Couldn't I wash in them and be cleansed?' So he turned and he went off in a rage. Naaman's servants went to him and said, 'My father, if the prophet had told you to do some great thing, would you not have done it? How much more then when he tells you, wash and be cleansed?' So he went down and dipped himself in the Jordan 7 times, as the man of God had told him, and his flesh was restored, and he became clean like that of a young boy. Then Naaman and all the attendants went back to the man of God. He stood before him and said, 'Now I know.'"
Now I know.
I'm glad already. I haven't even said a word yet. "But now I know that there is no God in all the world except in Israel." So please, I say please,
come on,
accept a gift from your servant. Come on and give God a hand clap.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
know if I can see the word, I'm already blessed, you know, already.
Come on.
I don't need to say anything else. It had a little robbery in it. A little testimony in it.
Yes, yes.
Amen, because it's good all by itself. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, touch me, Lord, and remove me out of the way.
Yes.
That your word come clearly and plainly before your people, you would have it to do.
Yes,
I sit down, God, and let your Holy Spirit send up.
Amen.
These are things I ask in Jesus' name.
Jesus.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. If I use for a topic today, I use the word sweet surrender.
Come on, man.
Sweet surrender, because really I'm discussing tonight a parallel in the first step of the 12-step program.
Come on.
And I want to share this scripture and discuss these parallels with what we know about the first step of the 12 steps. Amen. So there's a marriage between the steps, amen, and the word.
Yeah.
The steps and the word of God. There is no separation. They are intertwined as one. Amen. We admitted that we were powerless over our problems, that our lives had become unmanageable. Mm. You know, it can be very humiliating to admit that we're powerless.
Yes.
Especially if we're used to being in control.
Yeah.
You got any people out there used to being in control? Or used to thinking like you in control?
Come on.
See, we may be powerful in some areas of our lives, but out of control in terms of our addictive, compulsive behaviors.
Yes. Come on.
If we refuse to admit our powerlessness, mm-hmm. we may lose everything.
Mm-hmm.
Refusing to admit that one unmanageable part of our life may infect and destroy everything else.
Mm, yes.
In the scripture, the experiences of the Armenian army commander Naaman illustrate how this is true. He was a powerful military and political figure, a man of wealth, a position and power. He also had leprosy, which promised to bring about the loss of everything he held dear.
Okay.
Lepers were made outcasts from their families, from society. Ultimately, they faced a slow, painful, and disgraceful death.
Yeah.
Does that sound familiar to anybody here or anybody there?
Come on.
How many of us are neighbors?
Mm.
We've enjoyed wealth. We've enjoyed position. We've enjoyed power. We had that outward appearance of wealth, that outward appearance of position,
All right. That
outward appearance of power. But inside, we were also lepers.
Okay.
I was faced with the same dilemma myself. From the age of 13, my addictions controlled my life. A great athlete, headed to the East-West All-Star Game, being recruited by major colleges all over the country, but arrested for drug possession my senior year at the junior-senior prom. Yes. Smoking marijuana in the parking lot. I was arrested about the time the prom let everyone out, and you know, I was on Front Street. As everyone drove by in their cars going out on prom night, I stood with the cleanest arrested individual on the planet that night.
Come on.
I was headed for some type of sports glory, but now I'm headed for jail. And a stain that I couldn't erase. After college, I finished my first 13 years of management in position of power, but still drugging. Thinking I had it all together until it crumbled before my face and the faces of everyone that I knew. I was outcast from those I love and from society. See, Naaman heard about a prophet in Israel
Okay.
who could heal him. He found the prophet, and the prophet told him that in order to be healed, he needed to dip himself 7 times in the Jordan River.
Yes.
A river less desirable than others he knew. How many times have we been given advice to go to a meeting, to go do something that we should be doing, that should be part of our recovery, but it's not as desirable as those other things that we have on our agenda? Naaman went away outraged, having expected that his power would buy him an instant and easy cure. See, remember, he took all these talents, he took all these shekels, he took all these clothes, thinking that he was going to parlay and buy his way into recovery. See, somebody didn't want to come out tonight. Somebody didn't want to tune in tonight. But I invite you to put aside what you want and dip.
Come on.
Dip into this service. Dip into recovery. Dip into Recovery Church of Norfolk.
Come on.
There may be some other places that you feel like you can go dip and cleanse. And I'm not saying that you can't.
Come on.
But I know of a place that you can come and get the full support that we're able to offer. You can see we have support come all the way from Florida.
Hallelujah.
Back in the world, we used to say, dip, baby, dip.
Come on.
Amen. But I invite you to put aside what you want and dip.
Yes.
See, Naaman was not satisfied with the solution presented to him, although he himself sought out Elijah for the cure. Elijah didn't give him what he thought would work. He gave him the solution God had provided.
Amen.
Are we willing to use the solution God has provided? Amen. See, he's already provided in the earth some solutions for recovery. He's already provided in the earth some solutions for what it is you're going through. The 12 steps, the bridge, the church, the solutions are available for you.
Amen.
In the end, however, Naaman acknowledge his powerlessness, follow the instructions, and recover completely. I said Naaman acknowledged his powerlessness. He followed instructions. He recovered completely. You gotta repeat that with me.
Come on.
Number one, he what? Acknowledged his powerlessness. He followed instructions. And he recovered completely. Like Naaman, I saw the solution.
All right.
Treatment for my addiction, but I failed 2 drug tests and 2 times going through the 12-step treatment frontward and backwards.
Okay.
My solution seemed to be failing for me. But one day, after we were up all night partying, my wife decided she was going to go to church, and I said, I'm going also. But not really with the best intentions. I said, if you're going, I'm going to. That's the attitude I had. But that day, July 20, 2003, I surrendered my addiction.
Come on.
My problems and my selfishness to Jesus.
Amen.
And we both were saved on the same day.
Come on.
See, Jesus empowered and enabled me to walk through my sobriety from drugs. I had to acknowledge my powerlessness and admit my life was unmanageable. See, we have access to a solution in the 12 steps, but we also have access to the solution in the empowerment of the Holy Ghost. The Holy Spirit of God. We can use the 12 steps and dip. Wash and be clean. We can embrace the Holy Spirit and be dipped.
Hallelujah.
Oh, you missed that one. See, you can dip in the 12 steps.
Okay.
But only the Holy Ghost can dip you.
Come on. Hallelujah.
See, our diseases are life life-threatening as leprosy.
Okay.
In Naaman's day. They slowly separate us from our families and lead toward destruction of everything that is important to us. Mm-hmm. There's no instant or easy cure. The only answer is to admit our powerlessness.
Yes.
Humble ourselves and submit.
Yes.
Follow instructions. Submit to the process that would eventually bring recovery. I know it was Jesus and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
For
me. Amen.
Yes.
See, I knew the steps. I could recite them to you. But I was powerless in my own to keep those steps. Now I get to share the good news that there is hope.
Okay.
I get to share the good news that there is a highest power.
Amen.
I get to share the good news that there is a bomb in Gilead.
Yes. Yes.
The name of the Lord is a strong power.
Yes.
The righteous run in and are safe.
Yes.
Run in.
Yes.
Run in today.
Hallelujah.
Run like your life depends on it.
Amen.
I'm still running.
Come on.
Yes.
Every day I run in.
Amen.
Every day I dip in.
Come on.
Run, Forrest. Run, Forrest, run.
Come on.
Oh, I should say run, Robert. And run. And don't look back.
Okay.
Come on and give God a hand clap. You can have it to run if you can pass today. This is not one pill or one thing fits all. This is what dip and be dipped.
Amen.
The bridge is available for you.
Amen.
If there's anybody here tonight that says, I want the opportunity to not only dip in the 12 steps, but be dipped in by the Holy Spirit. The altar is open. You can come at this time. I extend to you the opportunity to come just as you are.
Hallelujah.
See, I came when I was in the midst of my brokenness.
All right.
Yes.
And when I came, I can't say I was completely sober because I've been up all night. Because
okay.
I couldn't have slept it off. It was still on me.
Come on.
Yes.
But when I got in,
okay.
What on me fell off of me.
Come on.
Hallelujah.
Praise God.
Hallelujah.
And what was on me.
Thank you, Lord.
Was removed from me.
That's right.
I had the power to stand. I had the power to overcome.
Amen.
And I'll tell you really quickly how that power manifested itself. That same day that we gave our lives to Christ, a person came to my house to give me cocaine. This stuff is not going to cost you a thing. This is a freebie.
Yep.
It's on me.
Yes.
But it's going to stay on you. Because it's not going to stay here.
Come on.
And when I turned them around, it looked as if it was unbelievable. That's how quickly the enemy wanted to come back and reclaim what he'd already done.
Yes. Come on.
Yes.
But I've been dipped.
Come on.
Hallelujah.
Something had already dipped me. Something had already gotten a hold of me.
Yeah.
Where I was able to say, no. You have to leave my house.
Glory.
And don't come back.
Yeah. Hallelujah.
Is there anybody out there now that would like to walk away from me? Whatever spiral you're in. Walk away from whatever situation you're in. You can come. I'm not going to ask you to come before the camera. But if you're coming, come right over here.
Come on.
Amen.
Amen.
Come on, give God a
hand.
Amen. Because this is not a public view. If you want to be part of this part, you got to be in the house.
Amen.
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 Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
So we're going to stop streaming and we're going to pray for him.
Hallelujah.
And we're going to pray for anybody else that would like to come. And afterwards, we're going to take a 10-minute, 15-minute break with some snacks, and then we'll come back for a share. I want to thank God for everyone that's out there. Father, in the name of Jesus, Touch those minds and those hearts, God, that have heard this word tonight. That they would be willing to dip as many times necessary to stay free from whatever held them captive. Father, we ask you to give them the strength and you give them the will, God, to make it into this place. So that we can love on them and support them and help them walk through those stages of sobriety. We love you. We honor you. We lift you up. In the mighty master's name of Jesus Christ. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Come on again.